Good morning and welcome to this fourth monthly webinar. And today we have invited two states, West Bengal and Jharkhand. So now I'll request West Bengal, Giri Sahab.
Good morning to you all. Now, Savitri West Bengal is going to present two case studies. One is on the Nabade composting and another is on poultry rearing. First, we are going to present our case studies on the Nabade composting. Before going to the presentation, we will request our director Samiti to say something about our activities of Samiti. Could you share something, sir?
Our Samiti is basically agriculture training, a government sponsored institute, and it was basically established in 1965, more than 50 years ago. In 2005, we have started to act as Samiti. So Samiti at present is doing a lot of work, like the conduction of postgraduate diploma in agricultural extension management, PGDEM, STRY, Deshi. Total in state, we are offering this Deshi course. More than 47 courses are going on, and besides it, a lot of short-term course, 3 to 5 days short-term courses for different extension functionaries of agriculture and allied sector. Publication, different publications, including success stories, newsletter, and other things, consultancies to the directly to the farmers, and also library and other things supported to the farmers. These are nutshell. We have our own farm, dairy, vermicompost area, the poly house, sentinet house, even the tissue culture lab, and biofertilizer training lab, soil testing lab. So there is a good infrastructure for training and education also. These are all in a nutshell for the Samiti. I would request Mr. Giri to take over and continue his presentation.
Sir, thank you, sir. Coming to our main presentation, the introductory session of different sessions on our farm, explaining the composition process of raw materials, preparation of vermicompost bed by heat method along with the advantages and disadvantages, preparation of vermicompost bed. Preparation of vermicompost bed to feed method along with the advantages and disadvantages. It was mainly the practical part. Then special characters and behaviors of earthworms, anatomy of earthworms, intercultural operations of vermiwas. Then exposure feed to a vermicompost unit, local vermicompost, successful vermicompost interfilers. Then preparation of different types of liquid organic manures and preparation of panchagobba. Preparation of botanical pesticides, neem and other materials. Then issues entrepreneurial with the development with special emphasis on vermicompost. Economics of vermicompost production. Preparation of bankable projects of vermicomposting in a simple simple manner. The main experts are our faculty members, Dr. Subhash Pal, Solanda, all are our Samiti faculty members. And their expertise and emailities are also given in the presentation. Mr. Origit Sen, the training program number is 1173. He is from Uttar Dinajpur, West Bengal. Uttar Dinajpur, that is North Dinajpur, North West Bengal. He is having a higher secondary HS agriculture and 2.3 acres of agricultural land with the cropping pattern of rice, mustard, then jute, rice and mustard or wheat. His average monthly income is around 15,000 per month. These are some action images during training session. and then a visit to a successful entrepreneur and certificate distribution ceremony. After the training, he organizes a demonstration also to the farmers and give advices to the farmers. There are some images given here. After the training, we also organize another training called SCABC, Agriclinics and Agribusiness Center. So he took that training also, Agriclinic and Agribusiness Center, and then he focuses on vermicompost training. Now he is giving extension service to the farmers regarding vermicomposting. His major learnings, he has gathered knowledge of different species of earthworm, learned different methods of vermicompost preparation, learned how to control predators and vermicompost units, learned how to enrich vermicompost with different ingredients, adopting best way to control predators, making enrich the vermicompost with different ingredients like a trichoderma, neem, etc. And his impact as a result of this training is the interest in the field visit has increased than earlier. Farmers training are conducted to disseminate the knowledge of vermicomposting, and several field trials are carried out to observe the responses of vermicompost in different crops. So this is the main presentation about vermicomposting. Now I will go to another presentation on poultry farming. Our second case study is poultry rearing. Regarding Samiti, West Bengal, our director has already discussed regarding the main part of the training, case study on poultry rearing, that this training program was organized on 25th November to 1st December 2018, organized here at Samiti, West Bengal, and organized by our training coordinator, Rana Prasad Chaturaj. The main session plans are the introductory sessions of poultry farming, different breeds of poultry, backward poultry farming, poultry housing, feed and feed preparation practices, litter management and brooding management, various diseases on poultry, both theoretical and practical, and the vaccinations of poultry. These are the main sessions. There are subdivided into another session. He has clubbed it. Experts are Dr. Sarvaswarup Ghosh, from our Krishi Vigyan Kendra, Dr. Soumen Ganguly, the veterinary officers of Government of West Bengal, Rana Pratap Chaturaj, the faculty of Samiti West Bengal, then the BLDO officers of Sonarpur block, local Sonarpur block, and our farm manager and the area and poultry unit. They are the main research questions of this training program. Mr. Ashok Kumar Rai, he is from Narayanpur, Patharputia block, that is south Chabbish Pargana, the sea coast belt of Sundarban area, South West Bengal. He is having 36 years old. Education is higher secondary, HS pass, 10 plus 2 education. He has 1.22 acre of land, and cropping pattern mainly he is doing is poultry farm. Around 5,000 birds he is rearing, and his secondary business is fishery. And average monthly income is around 25,000 per month. These are some images during the training program. This poultry farm, after the training program, there are also some disasters like Amphan, but after Amphan also, he has again tried his farm and running recently, he is doing around 5,000 birds. Then another secondary income is fishery. He is doing fishery as Sundarban is known for fishery also, brackish water fishery, he is doing fishery also. During innovativeness, after taking the training, he has got another training on agri-entrepreneurship orientation program from IIT Kharagpur. And his novelty of this program is he is doing poultry litter. From poultry litter, he is doing biofertilizer. From poultry litter, preparation of biofertilizer from poultry droppings. And major learnings are gather knowledge about different breeds of poultry barns, learning different models of low cost poultry housing, learn how to scientifically manage poultry barns, learn maintain of biosecurity in poultry farm and cost control of different diseases, learn about marketing linkage, adapting waste streams to control poultry diseases, cost minimization like feed vaccination, feed conservation ratio increased than earlier before the training program, service to the local farmers. Earlier he did not give it, now he can give service to the local poultry farmers and develop his future plan. Low cost poultry set increased, extension service to the poultry farmers, started innovative business of biofertilizers by utilizing poultry droppings. So these are the main learnings after his training. So thank you all. Over to Shailendra sir.
Thank you, Giri sir. Thank you for beautiful presentation on these two success story, poultry rearing and vermicompost. And I'm also thankful to Ghosh sir for explaining different activities of the Samiti and the kind of interest he takes in each and every activity of the Samiti. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, Giri sir. Now I'll request the Jharkhand team. And as I mentioned, that Jharkhand team again is going to cover two success stories. One is on commercial piggery rearing. This one is about Sri Manchan Bag. And the coordinator of this program was Sri Mohit Singh. And other one is orchard management. It is about Sri Rajendra Yadav. And the coordinator of this program was Sri Rakesh Kumar Singh. So maybe we can start with Abhishek ji.
Good morning, all of you. Myself, Abhishek, I'm the director in Jharkhand. On behalf of Director Samiti Jharkhand, welcome to today's presentation. Today, we pleased to welcome Mr. Mohit Kumar Singh, Deputy Director, Deputy Project Director from Atma Gumla, and Rakesh Kumar Singh, Deputy Project Director from Kota. Both are today they will be sharing with us the success stories here. Mr. Mohit, please.
Good morning, everyone. So I'm the Deputy Project Director, Mohit Singh, from Atma Gumla, and I'm presenting a success story on STRY on commercial piggery rearing and management. Samiti started the STRY training program from 2018-19 onwards in our district, and previously there were also training programs organized by STRY, but the KVK Gumla was playing major role on these training programs. The Samiti Gumla Samiti has a major role about guiding us to conduct the training programs of STRY, and he's always participating actively and giving us follow up for the training programs, how to proceed with the trainings and what initiatives we have to take. Second, the detail of STRY program, which was conducted, was on 24th to 29th September 2018, and among the training sessions, first is the scope, status, and prospects of piggery farming, and the third theory part, in which we covered description and geographical culture benefits upon commercial piggery farming, handling systems for piggery, theory part, the piglets and adult pigs needs different care, and therefore the handling system prescribed in different our trainers. Housing management of pigs, it was to make understand different house requirement as per age and male female pigs conditions. important breeds and pigs and their characteristics features. What are the popular breeds in India and can be taken in our district as well as state? And it was the farmer's choice which breed they can take for better investment and get higher profit. And the whole description was given to them. Preparing a formulation of low-cost feeds through locally available materials, the third part, location-specific feed arrangement for the pigs, which is the most required portion. Okay. So the feed management, second, feed management and importance of water and nutrient management, third part, understanding pigs for management nutrients and water needs. Production, reproduction of pigs and its management, third part, understanding its pigs production systems and reproduction cycles, management and pregnant sows and piglets and their housing management, third part, high risk during management of pregnant sows and piglets, disease management of pigs, how to manage disease in pigs, prevention and control of contagious and non-contagious diseases, how to manage various kinds of diseases in the pigs, vaccination schedule in pigs, importance of vaccinations, and what is the importance of timely vaccinations, and how we can avoid the disease effects on the pigs. Sustainable marketing strategy of pigs, existing and long-run marketing strategy for adapt for pig farming, impractical handling housing system of piggeries and pigs, visiting of a already rearing a farmer, and on that field, some practical exercises were done with housing managements and SXRs. Now the list of experts we have utilized was Dr. Rajesh Mathi. Tiwari. Now he's an extension worker at Ambassador Husbandry in district. Dr. B. Rao, Bannu Rao, is scientist in Ambassador and associated with Visa Agriculture University. Dr. Ravindra Kumar, scientist in Department of Ambassador, Visa Agriculture University. Dr. Vinod Kumar, he's a KVK scientist at our district, KVK Gumla. Dr. Lalit Kumar Ekka, he's head of the animal husbandry in our district. Dr. Mahinder Ram, extension worker in the Department of Animal Husbandry in our district. So these were the experts who were associated with us and are always providing us assistance in organizing and conducting the training programs of STRY. Also, they are the animal husbandry specialists, so dairy farmers are also attached to them for listening to the lectures. So here are the details of the youth we had selected for the success story. Mr. Manchinbeck is around the age of 36, matric plus, and the agricultural land he has acquired is 4 acres, out of which irrigation in 1.5 acre is available, and cropping patterns. Food grains he is producing in 2.4 acres, vegetables in 1.5 acre, and other land which is of 0.25 acres. The major learning for the skill-based training program, the selection of breeds. Here, the as we all know that Jharkhand is a tribal state, and also district is a highly tribal populated area. So, if a farmer is thinking of adopting of a pig farming, so it is not strange, and we can normally consider or advise him to take the advantage of pig rearing over here. But some major problems are with the selection of the breeds. So it is must be clear that what kind of breeds should be taken, which could be beneficial for the pig rearing. Checking next is checking out control of contagious and non-contagious diseases for rearing of pigs. Knowledge of contagious and non-contagious skills makes a difference. Then necessary care of care during the pregnant sow and piglets. Again, the pregnant sow and after the birth of the piglets, care should be taken so that death rate could be minimized. Housing management of pigs, since the there's a great care in taking up housing management picks, since other ages factors which are very taken very care of, so that the rhythm picks could be maintained easily and unharmful, or deaths could be avoided, so that the rain conditions for the pigs could be in good condition, favorable conditions, then feed management and pig rearing. Modification introduced by the rural youth, which was the starting with the housing management. He was just associated with T&D breed or Chasu, which is commonly called in Jharkhand. So he just managed somehow with two house systems with 7 pigs and 3 females. But he was not able to successfully manage the pig rearing in years of 2016, as he was not able to understand the management systems, the feeding, how to feed the pigs and taking the timely vaccinations or disease controls. That was lack for the farmer in the starting year. In 2018-19, he was provided the training program associated with the experts with animal husbandry field. So he got knowledge and was also in better communication with the animal husbandry officials. So the knowledge and his experience worked better for his pig farming. Extra care of piglets increased survival rate, which was less than 2 test counts. Learned lessons in training made possible for the feed management, what to adapt, what to feed. Adapt communication skills for nutrient vaccines of pigs, communicating with the officials. He gets regular contacts and the timely vaccinations or the what to vaccinate, when to vaccinate, the timely information he gets, or he is now easy for the new births for the pigs to rear them. The above changes couldn't apply previously in the lack of training, which I already told. And residential trainings, which are already giving in our KBK Training Institute and at Visaya Agriculture University. The problem with the farmers is that they can't afford to travel to distant places, 200 or 100 kilometers away from their home, and reside there and get the training programs. So it was a better chance and a better opportunity for the this year to have a training program nearby his village at Dumla and gain the knowledge for the pig rearing. Impact and result and challenge changes for after going the program. The lesson learned in the training and the efforts changed his life. He has become the icon among the farmers as a pig rearing farmer. Better lifestyle for family, well education for children. Now he's from a common farmer, he has now adapting and accommodating his family and his children to have a better education and a fruitful life. Encouraging several rooks, providing breed from his own farm. Now they is providing the T&D or Jharsuk breeds, new births. He's selling them to this several youths, and his making income as well as providing new breeds to the farmers, nearby farmers, to adopt the T&D breed and prepare for a commercial pig farming for themselves too. Market strategy and strengthen no risk for product marketing. There's a completely different story about pig rearing and the market strategy over this travel population over here, that the market produce are not usually taken at the marketplace and sold out there, but the vendors or the middleman, they come up to their own pig farm and collect these pigs, prepared pigs, And the marketing strategy over here changes the game. There's low risk of the selling of the pigs. So it is better future for the pig rearing farmers. Always ready to find gaps and overcoming them in pig farming. So the experiences are working quite well for this farmer. In starting year, he fought very hard to get or arrange feeds for the his pigs. And for knowledge gap, it was very, very downfall for him that how to provide feed. He was losing money in buying the feeds for the pigs. So the knowledge gap has now overcome. Now, next module has taken place for him. Now his cheap cost method he's adopting and providing feeds for the his pigs. The method is adopting that he has managed to collect the waste food of hotels in his village areas. He's just providing empty dumps to these hotel areas in his two hotel areas in his locality, and the raw waste which are being collected in 1 or 2 days, he's just collecting them and providing to the pigs. So the 70% of the feed arrangement which is costlier for the in pig farming, is accommodating in a cheaper way. New thing that the feed, the quantity of rice buns or the carbohydrates which are required for the pigs. He has installed a rice mill at his own home. By this, he is already preparing maize meal or rice meal. The rice buns collected by the other farmers is punishing that, and it is collecting the feed arrangements for the pigs at his own home. And other business is also doing well, sometimes with the pig farming. Now the economics, the income from pig farming are in two kinds, which is his getting mature pigs. The mature pigs of 1.5 years age, varying of its cage difference from 80 to 100 kgs. The vendors which are collecting them, and it is almost selling approximately of 16 to 20 pigs yearly, and it is 2000 kg per kg of this sale price, around 20 to 16,000 he's collecting individual from one pig. Sale of piglets, around 45 to 50 piglets yearly he's selling, and per piglet he's selling for 3,000 rupees. Now the getting the waste products from the rearing of the pigs, he has adapting to collect this waste matters just in a pit size, and his turning towards of organic farming or the getting the organics to his crop farms. Total pure income in his term for the piggery farming, he is getting out of 3.5 lakhs, which is highest in our district. So this is the part of the economics of this Munchin Beck. This was the first training, some photographs of sharing of the Munchin Beck, which he participated in 2018. Our veterinary officer over here is giving some basic knowledge about the pigs, and the Munchin Beck over here is attending the meeting. He's receiving the certificate. The second training program in 2020 recently, and giving the students the practical knowledge in piggery farm. They visit at the Munchin Beck's farm. The farmers were getting information about basic knowledge and his experiences in this training schedule of STRY. Now impact. Gumla district. Rearing pig is very common, but with the desi breed of pig comes several problems in rearing. Firstly, with disease. Secondly, open system of rearing, which only develops enemies more. Less growth in body mass, no controlled feed management, which is desperately needs breed improvement and better management practices. The success of pig farming mentioned by he made deep impact among the farmers and is willing to adopt commercial pig farming for the other farmers. Distant farmers contact him for improved piglets, breeds, and farm learnings. The dice of TND or the Just Craft is getting well populated over here, other than the desi breeds. Government society like JTDS, Jack and Travel Development Society, which are also collecting piglets for their assistance for constructing of piggery houses and piggery farms for the other farmers. Several youths are inspired with him and eager to develop or convert their desi pig farms into a just or TND breed pig farm. Thus, the youth has shown people a new source of income other than the crop cultivation and generates self-employment for rural. This is the learning and impact of this munchkin bag for the other farmers. Thank you and thanks so much.
Yeah, thank you, Mahitji, for such a comprehensive presentation covering almost every aspect of the success story, including economics. Now we can have the other success story by Sri Rakesh Kumar Singh on orchard management.
Details of SKR by Karim Venu, Atma Gota Jharkhand. Detail of training 18 to 24 January 2021. Training contract, Deputy PT, sir. Main. Session plan, mein, sir. Session plan. Number one, concept of orchard management. इसमें सर मैंने ब्रीफ कवरेज अंदर जो सेशन में सर कवर किया गया उसमें स्कोप एंड इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ ऑर्चर मैनेजमेंट इन मैंगो विद कंटेंट टू गोड्डा डिस्ट्रिक्ट प्रोडक्शन प्रोडक्टिविटी ऑफ मैंगो. सेकंड में सर ए प्रिंसिपल ऑफ गोड्डा एग्रीकल्चरल प्रैक्टिस इन मैंगो ऑर्चर्ड. इसमें सर सॉइल क्लाइमेट रिक्वायरमेंट एंड साइट सिलेक्शन फॉर और कॉमर्शियल मैंगो कल्टिवेशन प्रिंसिपल एंड प्रैक्टिस इन्वॉल्व इन प्लान of planning of mango cultivation. Third, sir, concept of high density and ultra density plantation of mango. Establishment of commercial high density mango orchard, GAP, GAP. Requirement in mango production, harvesting, grading, packaging, and ripening of mango. Water requirement and weed management mango orchard. Benefit of micro irrigation. Method of irrigation of mango orchard, micro irrigation technique layout and designing in traditional and using high density mango orchard with and with management. Sir, number five, layout of planting and spacing for plantation of mango. इसमें सर हम लोग practical करवाए थे सर ये KBK के जो field है वहाँ पर जा करके. Pit digging, filling of pits, importance, varieties, characters of varieties for impact commercial value. इसके साथ साथ सर इनको सारा कुछ बताया गया कि pit digging कितना करना है, उसमें filling कैसे करेंगे सर, और importance variety characters के बारे में पूरी जानकारी दी गई. Fertilizer management सर, इसके तहत role of major and micro nutrients in quality fruit production and the grain bearing deficiency symptom of major and micronutrients. Video film on orchard and exposure visit of mango, guava and lemon orchard sir, जो यहाँ पर available है सर हमारे campus में भी 25 acre का सर farm बना हुआ है. Nutrient management and regular bearing in mango orchard. इसमें सर डॉक्टर भूषण सर के द्वारा बताया गया सर concept of regular bearing in mango, role of hormones in regular bearing and method of application. Nutrient management in pre-bearing orchard and bearing orchard year by schedule. जो इसमें सर मैं हमारे यहाँ पर जो एक्सपर्ट थे सर डॉक्टर रविशंकर सर पीसी सर और डॉक्टर हेमंत कुमार चौरसिया, ये हॉर्टिकल्चर से थे सर, और इसके अलावा सर प्लांट प्रोटेक्शन से डॉक्टर सूर्यभूषण थे, डॉक्टर अमितेश जी थे, और फार्म मैनेजर थे डॉक्टर राकेश। डिटेल्स अबाउट यूथ कवर्ड एंड सक्सेस स्टोरी में सर एक राजेंद्र यादव है सर, सोनार चक पत्थरगामा ब्लॉक के, जो कि आईसी हैं, और 3 acres में सर इन्होंने जो अपने लैंड में बेरल लैंड में जो काम किया सर वो बहुत अच्छा किया है इन्होंने, 500 पपाया और 1 acre में सर नया अभी मैंगो ऑर्चर्ड लगाया है, जो कि उन्होंने फोटोग्राफ भेजा था सर, मैंने इसमें ऐड नहीं कर पाया, ये अच्छी तरीके से सर किए हैं, और ये बीच बीच में हमसे संपर्क भी में भी रहते हैं सर, ऐसे 2-3 इसमें से हमारा सर सक्सेस स्टोरी बनाने लायक हो गए हैं सर। इसके बाद सर मेजर लर्निंग फ्रॉम द स्किल बेस्ड ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम एज एक्सप्रेस्ड बाय द प्रोटेस्टेंट, स्कोप एंड इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ ऑर्चर्ड मैनेजमेंट, हार्वेस्टिंग, ग्रेडिंग, पैकेजिंग एंड रेपनिंग ऑफ मैंगो, माइक्रो इरिगेशन टेक्निक एंड लेआउट मेथड ऑफ प्लांटिंग, पिट डिगिंग, टिलिंग ऑफ पिट्स, इंपॉर्टेंट वैरायटीज, स्पीशीज। और ये सर मेजर लर्निंग में सर इसको डॉक्टर चौरसिया सर ने सर बहुत अच्छे से सिखाया सर, प्रूनिंग ट्रेनिंग एंड कैनोपी मैनेजमेंट टेक्निक, इसमें सर ये इंटरवेंशन में आ रहा था मेकिंग ए न्यू ऑर्चर्ड लेआउट, फर्टिलाइजर मैनेजमेंट, वाटर मैनेजमेंट बाय ड्रिप इरिगेशन एंड वीड मैनेजमेंट इन न्यू एंड ओल्ड ऑर्चर्ड, क्योंकि उसमें कुछ स्टूडेंट ऐसे थे सर जिनको पहले से बाग बगीचा था और वो अपना विस्तार करना चाह रहे थे, क्योंकि न्यू थे तो वो अच्छे से समझ सके सर इसलिए आए थे। प्रूनिंग ट्रेनिंग एंड प्रोपोगेशन फॉर वेल ऑर्चर्ड मैनेजमेंट, इंटरक्रॉपिंग बिटवीन 2 rows ऑफ पपाया एंड वेजिटेबल्स, इम्पोर्टेंस इम्पैक्ट एज ए रिजल्ट ऑफ चेंजेस अडॉप्ट आफ्टर गोइंग थ्रू द प्रोग्राम, establishing per hectare a new orchard which will be ready by layout planning, make a layout planning for maximum plant field coverage and good quality variety selection before planting, after fruit harvesting and then guiding should be done for maximum income, how to become success in mango orchard, to increase the number of fruits, size of fruits and good quality of fruits। सर हाई डेंसिटी ऑर्चर्डिंग के लिए सर एक हम लोग ने उनको जो बताया सर इनसे काफी वो लोग इम्प्रेस हुए और वो लोगों ने समझा कि जो है सो अच्छे इनकम इसमें कर सकते हैं सर। सर नेक्स्ट स्लाइड सर। सर इसमें मैंगो का जो अम्रपाली है सर, साइट्रस का और गुआवा का सर बताया गया है सर, स्पेसिंग, प्लांटिंग डेंसिटी, प्लांट्स पर हेक्टेयर, यील्ड और परसेंटेज इंक्रीज ओवर ट्रेडिशनल मेथड सर। इकोनॉमिक्स ऑफ हाई डेंसिटी मैंगो ऑर्चर्ड में कॉस्ट ऑफ एस्टेब्लिशमेंट RS 2.98 लाख पर हेक्टेयर, टोटल मेंटेनेंस कॉस्ट सर 6.96 लाख इन 10 इयर्स, टोटल इनकम ऑफ RS 13 लाख इन 10 इयर्स, आफ्टर 10 इयर्स ए नेट प्रॉफिट ऑफ 2 लाख पर ईयर कैन बी ऑब्टेन्ड फ्रॉम 1 हेक्टेयर ऑफ हाई डेंसिटी मैंगो ऑर्चर्ड। मार्केटिंग में सर अभी यहाँ पर लोकल मार्केट जो है सर वही अवेलेबल है, बाकी जो मार्केट है सर वो काफी दूर में है, थोड़ा देवघर है और कलकत्ता सर लगभग 250 किलोमीटर पर है। आफ्टर हार्वेस्टिंग एट ए प्रॉपर मेच्योरिटी स्टेज फ्रूट आर ग्रेड एंड पैकेज इन बास्केट फॉर डिस्टेंट मार्केट। और ये सर कुछ फोटोग्राफ्स हैं जो हम लोगों ने ट्रेनिंग के टाइम में किया था, और इसमें एक यहाँ पर SDO साहब हैं सर, सब डिविजनल ऑफिसर, सब डिविजनल मजिस्ट्रेट जो कि आए थे और उन्होंने भी काफी प्रोत्साहित किया, जो सीखने वाले थे सर उनसे सवाल जवाब भी किए, और ये यहाँ पर सर बडिंग और ग्राफ्टिंग सिखाते हुए सर डॉक्टर चौरसिया सर हैं सर, और ये ड्रिप इरिगेशन सर दिखाते हुए ड्रिप इरिगेशन का लाभ वगैरह सब कुछ बताया गया सर, ये लेमन का है। उसके बाद ये जो ये गुआवा का सर कटिंग करके लगाया गया है उसको दिखाया गया, पिट डिगिंग का बताया गया सर, इम्पैक्ट ऑन अदर फार्मर्स यूथ सर। सर नेक्स्ट सर, इम्पैक्ट ऑन अदर फार्मर्स यूथ, इम्पैक्ट जो हुआ सर ये जेनरेट्स सेल्फ एम्प्लॉयमेंट फॉर रूरल यूथ एंड बेटर लाइफ स्टाइल फॉर फैमिली मेंबर्स एंड वेल एजुकेशन फॉर चिल्ड्रेन। convert waste land into cultivable land through plantation of orchard and cultivable vegetable crops as a intercropping. Number of orchard plantation increase after training program. Encouraging several rural youth for planting of fruit timber plant for self-employment and livelihood. Always ready in finding gaps and overcoming them in orchard management. Icon among farmers in orchard plantation. Thank you, sir.
So thank you team Jharkhand for presenting success story on commercial piggery rearing and orchard management. I once again express my sincere thanks, gratitude to each one of you, all the KVKs, Atmas, coordinators from KVKs, project directors from Atmas, senior officers placed at Samitis looking after coordinating activities of the STRY, and of course directors of Samitis for participating in this training program. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.